So it's been a while since I've made any talking videos, and a lot of the reason has been that things went off the rails after I quit making videos last. Oh man, it was a hard period trying to keep alive because I lost this job that I had been making good money, and then I was just in a much sicker place, and I was unable to get work similar to that. I ended up doing a whole variety of things to try and stay alive, and just had a whole variety of horrible things happen. Yeah, so at this point, I am in a good place. I'm married. This is actually my left hand. The video is gonna do this, and I've come up pretty good treatment now. I probably seem a little bit drunk right now. I feel like simultaneously very clear headed from the treatment protocol for Bartonellosis. So, very, like, drunk, you know, it's very, very brained off for me this time. I'm not tired, I'm not feeling, like, really toxic or any of that. It's just, I get dizzy, I get insomnia. It's 5:30 in the morning, I'm not sleeping at all. So, sort of the details of what happened in the past is I lost my job. I had to start my own business, essentially. Because I couldn't really get another office job with my level of problems of health at that point. And then a little wise, just as I felt like that was getting going, I had a series of head injuries, concussions, a car accident. I was housebound for a whole lot of time. I was bedbound for about 6 months. I had a stress fracture in my back. I got the meth poisoning. From probably Bartonellosis had to do with that. I just felt like I was grinding my body into the ground, and I kept reaching out for help, and my family didn't care. So it was a grind. I felt like I was driving a car while it had like engine trouble, and I had to somehow keep a roof over my head, and I ate so much rice. I did so much stuff to save money. I was in debt for so many years too, because ultimately, I know people say, oh, you should never spend more than you need, but ultimately it was probably the right choice to strategically use debt to try and keep myself going. I also had to evacuate my apartment I literally have lost count. I had to like sit there and think about it to remember. I think it's either 7 or 8 times in the span of 3 years or 4 years. I don't know exactly what it is, but something around that. From just different, like the apartment would become moldy or too moldy for me, and I was getting sick and I had to move out. Or 2 or 3 different times, 3 times actually, people used drugs in my apartment, and that forced me to move three times, yeah. And then not even just those times, I also experienced like secondhand drugs in other apartments too. Because I ended up having to live in such cheap places because of having a mold illness. I had to live in like new apartments for them not to be moldy, new or very highly renovated, good quality apartments. And then in order to afford it on my like cheap budget, I ended up living in like cheap cities or cheap parts of cities or cheap like rundown areas, and there's a bunch of random BS that happened there, like including a lot of drugs, and I basically did a lot of drugs secondhand, man. And I went through a lot of drug detox too, not just that, whatever. I guess I feel like I haven't planned this video at all. But yeah, what I'm getting to is, so I've recently gotten together, and I'm with a good doctor, and I'm doing this. Dr. Marty Ross has his treelime.net. He's got these protocols. It's like the same. It's what you get for most any other illness. You have an illness, you look up the research-based protocol, and you go and try and do it. Maybe you modify it if you need to do it. But really, I've never had that for Lyme. I've never had that for bartonellosis. I've never had that for babesiosis, any of that. But I mean, finally, I happened upon it. My doctor supports me doing it. She actually, like, the reason I found it, so I'm doing it, and you know, I have much less Bartonella now, and it's just mind-blowing to realize, like, I was, like, missing a lot of my brain, and I mean, I still am. I'm not saying I'm, like, there now or anything, but I'm getting a pretty good insight as this hurts, and the clearing it all out happens. Like, my gosh, like, I was missing so much blood flow to my cortex, and I feel like I'm turning into my old self that I was before the Bartonella took over, because apparently Bartonella causes small vessel disease, and that really restricts blood flow to little parts of your brain that just have, like, maybe one little capillary going in and out of them, and one little small blood vessel, and if it gets stopped up with bartonellosis, that part of the brain is not getting good blood flow. And I'm realizing that's probably part of why I was not healing well from all these injuries over the years. In addition to everything else I said was going on, I got this debilitating injury issue. It's not EDS, it's not ehlers-danlos. I don't ever get joint dislocations. It's more just that every single part of my body, it's not even restricted to skin or muscle, it's bones, it's brain, it's like anything, gets injured extraordinarily easily. And then it just doesn't heal. I have to, like, baby it to the extreme degree to get it to heal and do all these supportive things to it. I've had a corneal abrasion for almost 3 years now, and that's a lot of why I haven't been making videos, because in order to, like, make a real serious video, like, you kind of have to, like, you know, talk in a certain way and look at the camera, and I just can't right now with my eye, and I frequently have to sort of, like, relieve pressure on my eye. I always have to have eye drops within reach to it starts to stick, and I'm trying to heal it. It really takes a lot of discipline not to mess up your eye by reading stuff. Daily, like, chores can mess it up, so I have to be super careful how much I do, like, looking at things online. It's really changed my life having this injury. I have not really been able to read books for this whole 3 years, and I do a lot of things to support the healing, like red light supports the healing, and I take certain supplements to support the healing. I don't know, there's certain things I could do that are kind of invasive that I don't really want to do yet, because I think I can get there without the invasive procedures, and I personally feel also with my health history, it's risky to do invasive procedures, because I don't even know if those would work for me, and it might make me, I don't even know if, like, what am I supposed to injure your eye to, like, stimulate it to heal? I'm like, I don't even know if I'll heal from the, like, therapeutic eye injury, you know. But anyway, it also seems like my injuries are starting to improve with the Bartonella treatment. I'm also thinking, I've watched a lot of my old videos, and they really, I'm glad I have them. I'm really glad, because it helps me remember who I was and stuff, and different, you know, different ups and downs. And I've been keto and an animal-based carnivore for a while, and my face is much thinner. I do look older. My skin is frankly ironically a little better than it used to be, even like wrinkle wise, because I use a ton of charcoal and I'm super into anti-aging. But anyway, I'm talking a lot, but I'm on this protocol now. I'm taking rifampin, 600 milligrams a day for bartonellosis. Bartonellosis has been my major symptom causer, I believe, this whole time for me. I'm on Malarone because I've started having Babesia while I treat the Bartonella, and I'm gonna stop it. Yeah. Anyways, I'm on methylene blue, which is really, really antibacterial. Like, so I'm on methylene blue, and then a bunch of immune stuff and a bunch of. I don't really want to have to answer tons of questions about it. Just go to treatlime.net and Bartonella group on Breaking Down Bartonella on Facebook, and you'll see information is I'm just realizing what I lost, you know, by not having this treatment, and it's really unforgivable that this all went down. It's I don't know if I can really pin the blame specifically on anything or anyone, but it's rough. It's harsh. I'm so much more angry about it now than I've ever been. And you don't really know what you've lost until you get something back. You don't really know what you're missing, you know. And so it's been a lot for me to process. It's been almost like it's almost like getting in the way of me healing, or the getting in the way of what I need to be doing with the die-off and everything. Because I'm just like, whoa, like, I cannot believe, like, what I lost. And I personally believe I had narcissistic parents, and they just did the classical narcissist and covert narcissist thing, and they, I saw it. It's hard to really explain, but I saw it firsthand. I saw the emails, I saw the decisions, I saw the attitudes, I saw everything, and I was treated like a trash object. And I think a lot of us patients are. A lot of us who are sick for a long time are. Unfortunately, have personality disordered parents that cannot rise to the challenge of having a child with this. You know, your child gets it at a point where they haven't built up enough financial or, you know, insurance, whatever, capital, or, you know, the ability to qualify for enough SSDR or whatever to handle it on their own. The kid gets it in high school, you know. I got sick when I was in college, so anyways, they botched this, and unnecessarily, and it's unforgivable. I don't know, I mean, I know there's all this is the first, like, unforgivable thing that I feel has ever happened to me, and I'm struggling with what to do with it, and I blogged and journaled a little bit about it, but I think the thing to do is just think about others, basically, and just be like, others deserve to have, like, I'm on earth for a reason, and others deserve for that reason to be fulfilled, and so if I need to protect myself from narcissism, or if I need to treat my Bartonella, or, you know, whatever I need to do to fulfill that purpose, you know, that's healthy and stuff, I will do it, and I'm not going to sacrifice my life and my purpose to, you know, people that don't love me, and you know, like, I'm planning to, I don't want to say too much, but, so that's that, that's where I'm at, and, you know, just pushing through the treatment, just trying to push the doses higher if I can, trying to push the killing higher. I'm combining everything with ozone still, so it's antibiotics plus ozone, which is a really wonderful combination. They really work well together for me, at least for Bartonella in particular. Ozone doesn't seem to do much for Babesia for me, but, so yeah. And I'm just trying to push forward for, because I realized, like, I have the rest of my life now. I used to just feel like I was just trying a lot for years. It felt like the point of my life was, I'm sorry, I don't have my partial intuitively aware of this thing. I have my root canals removed, that's why I don't have teeth there. It was for healing. But anyways, whatever. This is the first time I've done this in years. I literally have lost my train of thought, unfortunately. I do have a lot of, like, sometimes my memory, working memory feels really good, and then sometimes it hurts, and I just feel like I can't do working memory, but, yes, I just feel like I need to give things to the world, and, you know, I'm pushing through the treatment, and I'm trying to be healthy, and, trying to come out of this alive, because for a long time, I felt like all I was trying to do was just not get to the point where I was going to have to, you know, off myself, from being too sick. I was like, hopefully I will get, I'll somehow manage to continue to have enough money and continue to have enough treatment that it doesn't get that bad to that point, and I will hopefully be able to keep that game up until I die and after that. Basically, my was just to hopefully live out the course of my life and die a natural death that was not from tick borne infections. That was a pretty low goal. Anyway, so now I'm like, no, I really want to, like, I feel a responsibility to, I've been watching a lot of near-death experiences too, and that's really, like, putting a spin on all of this for me, that, like, I'm here. I'm a really strong Enneagram 4, and that's the stuff that really makes me alive, and watching back my old videos, all the music, all the random characters, I'm a horrible singer, but it really does mean something to me emotionally, watching that, and, I'm just like, that's what makes me alive, that's what I feel like my purpose is, or that's what, you know, whatever. So I'm hoping to do more of that. I feel like I will also, like, go back to the thing where I constantly read and constantly write, and, you know, hopefully, I just need to get over my fears, because it's really difficult to even make a video without getting injured. I typically, like, don't even wear clothes while I'm alone, because I get injured so easily by clothing. So this is, you guys are lucky that I even have clothes on, you know. I really at this point can't do the thing where I do all the makeup, this video stand, and got the, you know, no, like, this is all you're gonna get from now. So anyway, I don't even know if this video is gonna upload or not, given how long it is, but, summary is that, you never know when, like, you can hit on the protocol, or when someone's just like, oh, here's the protocol, or we finally get a doctor that's actually working with you, or you finally get on the right drugs, you finally get on the right antibiotics, everything, you know, finally, the bacterial levels fall, and the toxicity levels fall, and you're like, oh my gosh, like, there's so much possibility, and I'm... So I don't really want to go back. I don't want this to be like an illness channel or whatever, but whatever. It's a life channel, okay? And I will say, one of the things that really means the most to me is something that I saw in this movie, No Zone Blindness, where he said that it's a gift. His blindness wasn't even a gift, and he realized that it was a gift that God gave him, and not a gift he would wish on anyone, and not a gift he really wanted, but it was a gift nonetheless. And I can't find the quote, but it made me cry in the movie theater watching this documentary, and it is so true. Lyme disease is a spiritual enhancer. It has been a massive gift to my life. It has been a teacher. It's been something that's challenged me and pointed me and taught me so many lessons, and so, like, I'm so grateful, you know, and it's